Hello. So, that was like an introduction. Now for some preaching to the choir on the subject of how come it is that the further in you go, the bigger it gets. I remember the very, very first time I smoked DMT. It was sort of a benchmark, you might say. And I remember that this friend of mine who always got there first visited me with this little glass pipe and this stuff which looked like orange mothballs. And since I was a graduate of Dr. Hoffman's, I figured there were no surprises. So the only question I asked was, how long does it last? And he said, about 5 minutes. So I did it. And there was something like a flower, like a chrysanthemum in orange and yellow that was sort of spinning. And then it was like I was pushed from behind and I fell through the chrysanthemum into another place that didn't seem like a state of mind. It seemed like another place. And what was going on in this place, aside from the tastefully soffitted indirect lighting and the crawling geometric hallucinations along the domed walls, what was happening was that there were a lot of beings in there. A lot of what I call self-transforming machine elves. Sort of like jeweled basketballs, all dribbling their way toward me. And if they'd had faces, they'd have been grinning, but they didn't have faces. And they assured me that they loved me, and they told me not to be amazed, not to give way to astonishment. And so I watched them, even though I wondered if maybe I hadn't really done it this time. And what they were doing was they were making objects come into existence by singing them into existence. Objects which looked like Fabergé eggs from Mars morphing themselves with Mandaean alphabetical structures. They looked like the concrescence of linguistic intentionality put through a kind of hyperdimensional transform into three-dimensional space. and these little machines offered themselves to me, and I realized when I looked at them that if I could bring just one of these little trinkets back, nothing would ever be quite the same again. And I wondered, where am I? And what is going on? And it occurred to me that these must be holographic viral projections from an autonomous continuum that was somehow intersecting my own. And then I thought, a more elegant explanation would be to take it at face value and realize that I had broken into an ecology of souls, and that somehow I was getting a peep over the other side. Somehow I was finding out that thing that you cheerfully assume you can't find out. But it felt like I was finding out. And it felt, and then I can't remember what it felt like, because the little self-transforming tykes interrupted me and said, don't think about it. Don't think about who we are. Think about doing what we're doing. Do it. Do it now. Do it!